Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Electromagnetic field theory, and we have started the numericals based on the Bio-Savart law. So, in the last portion of the lecture, we have started this example, okay, and we have solved the Hx for this. So now the Hy, okay. So here is Hy now. As this is the infinity, so we cannot draw a line from the infinity to this point of observation. Okay, so this is the conductor extending from 0 to infinity, and this is the point of observation. So for the alpha, we can draw the okay, this is a perpendicular line alpha. So we will call it alpha 1 dash. Now for the for the alpha 2, so we will consider it 90 degree, because we will draw a line perpendicular to it, and so we cannot draw the line from the infinity to this point of observation, so this will be automatically 90 degree. Okay, so this is alpha 2 dash. So alpha 1 dash, again apply the tangent inverse, okay, this time minus tangent inverse, this 0.3 over 0.5, we will get minus 36.9. alpha 2 is 90 degree, so putting the values alpha 2 dash minus alpha 1 dash, okay, the current is again 8, and now rho y, okay, there is the rho y is 0.4. so 0.4, take the values, we will get this. Now superposition to add these two, hx plus hy, so this is hx is this and hy is this. Okay, so we will get h is equal to 20 over pi if in the direction of a pi ampere per meter. Okay, now next example based on the Bio-Savart law, you have to find delta H2 at point P2, at point P1 I1 rho L1, okay, is equal to this. So the product of I1 delta L1 is given, that is 2 pi in the direction of az. P1 is 4 comma 0 comma 0, P2 is 0 comma 3 comma 0. B part is again I1a delta L1 is this, and the points have been changed. In C part, the I1 delta L1 is this, and the points have been changed. Okay, so now the solution, as we know that the dH2 due to small portion is equal to this, so we can represent d by delta, the same thing, because here we have delta in the form of delta, so delta, okay, H2 is equal to this. Now P1 is this, so R1 is along AX, there is no Y and Z value. P2 is this, so position vector for the point 2 will be 3 in the direction of A1. Okay, so R is equal to R2 minus R1, so R2 is 3AY and R1 is 4AX. So this is the R vector, and R absolute is equal to 3 square plus 4 square whole square root is equal to 5. Okay, so now putting the values in equation number 1, I1 delta L1 is given for the part A, it is equal to 2 pi in the direction of AZ. Okay, and R is this, so okay, so now AX cross, this is a cross multiplication, I have already told you, so AZ cross AX and AZ cross AY, so when we multiply, we will get this AZ cross AX AY and az cross ay is minus ax. Okay, and the rest of the values, okay, r absolute is 5 and 2 pi micro, which is given, okay, micro ampere meter. So B part, the P one is this, so R from for the point, position vector for the point will be 4ax minus 2ay plus 3az, and for the point 2, position vector will be 3ay. Okay, now R is equal to R2 minus R1, so this only y will be minus, okay, 3y plus 2, so 5, the rest is unchanged. So, and this is the R, and now R absolute is R square plus 5 square plus 3 square whole square root is equal to 7.07 meter. Okay, so putting the values in equation number 1 again, now the I1 delta L1 is given, that is 2 pi in the direction of AZ, same micro, okay, so 2 pi micro AZ, R is this, and R absolute is 7.07. okay, now again cross multiplication, AZ cross AX, AZ cross AY, and when we multiply AZ cross AZ, so it will be 0. Okay, so we will left with only X AX and AY. Now the C part, same thing, P1 is this, so R1 will be, position one vector will be this, R2, P2 is this, so R2 will be equal to this. Okay, so again R is equal to R2 minus R1, so X will be minus with X, Y will be minus with Y, Z will be minus with Z, so we will get R, net R is equal to this. Now R absolute, squaring all terms and then square root, so we will get 5.92. now putting the values in equation number 1, so now again the I dot dl is 2 pi, but now this is the extra term, okay, with this, and again micro, so 2 pi this extra term, micro cross, this is the R, this is the R absolute. Now the cross multiplication of this with this plus this with this plus this with this. Now cross multiplication of this with this plus this with this plus this with this. Okay, so the same will be 0. AX cross AX will be 0. AY cross AY will be 0. Okay, and we have already discussed all these things in the very first lectures of this course, okay, in the clockwise direction. So AX cross AY is equal to AZ, AY cross AZ is equal to AX, AZ cross AX is equal to AY, but in the clockwise direction, AX cross AY will be minus AY. Similarly, AY cross AX will be minus AZ, AZ cross AY will be minus AX. Okay, so we will get this. That is the end of the numerical number 8.2, drill 8.2. Now, drill 8.1. Now, drill 8.2, H is this given. We have already derived this as well, and it is in the direction of A phi. Okay, now H, we have to find the H in RCS. Although rest of the values are in cylindrical coordinate system, but we have to, the end result must be in RCS. Okay, so now the point is P 1.5 comma 2 comma 3, I is given, okay, in the direction of AZ, the conductor extends from, okay, we have three parts, the conductor in part A is extending from 0 to 6, the other is from 6 to infinity, means infinite conductor, C is also infinite from minus infinity to plus infinity. So now the solution, as we know that H is equal to this, so this is equation number one. Okay, now rho is equal to x square plus y square in RCS. Okay, so 1.5 x square y is 2. So because we are in need of rho, so for that purpose we find the rho value first. Now in the sketch for part A, the conductor carrying the current carrying conductor is extending from 0 to 0 to 6. Okay, A is 0, B is 6. Okay, the point of observation is somewhere here. Okay, so 3 along the Z, so it's actually in the mid of these two. Okay, so now draw the line from the lower end and the upper end. Okay, so and this is the perpendicular line. Okay, so this will be alpha 1 with the lower end, okay, and alpha 2 with the upper end line and the perpendicular line, so alpha 2. Okay, so now alpha 1, we have two right angle triangles, so one will be for alpha 1 and other will be for alpha 2. So alpha 1 is equal to minus tangent inverse 3 over rho is 2.5. okay, so 3 over 2.5, this is 3 and this is rho, perpendicular, this is base. Okay, negative sign indicates that the angle is measured in negative z axis. Okay, now alpha 1 is this. So alpha 2 is tangent inverse. Okay, this is actually 6 minus 3. This is 3, so this will be 6 minus 3, means 3 distance. So 3 divided by 2.5. So alpha 2 is this. Now putting in equation number 1, you will get everything is ready. H is this, but now this H is in CCS, so for transformation we will use this method. Okay, hx, hy, hz, these are unknown, and cos phi minus sin phi 0, sin phi cos phi 0, 0, 0, 1, h rho, h phi, hz. Okay, now this is the h, the known h is in a rho only, so the h rho h h phi sorry h phi, so rho and z will be 0, so only the h phi value. Okay, so we will get h x this, h y this, h z this. Okay, now b part, the conductor is now extending from 6 to infinity. Okay, so again from 6 to infinity, yes, and the point of observation is still there at point 3. This is the point of observation at z height 3. Okay, z height 3. So now draw the line from the lower end of the conductor. And again, we can now draw the line for the upper end because it is at infinity. So for that purpose, we will draw a parallel line with this infinite line. Okay, so alpha 2 will be automatically equal to 90 degree and alpha 1 is this. Okay, this small angle. Again, right angle triangle. So alpha 1 will be tangent inverse 3 by 2.5. Okay, this length is 3. Okay, 3 and this is 6, so 6 minus 3, 3. 3 over 2.5. Okay, the rho is 2.5. So alpha 1 is this. Now alpha 2 is 90 degree. Putting the values in equation number 1, you will get h. And now again, transforming this from CCS to rectangular coordinate system. So again, we have only the phi term, so the phi term, rest are 0. Solve this matrix, you will get this H. Okay. Now the C part, now the current carrying conductor is extending from minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay, so now in both of these cases we cannot draw the line from minus infinity to point of observation, which is at height 3, and so we will draw a parallel line for the this alpha 1 and parallel line for alpha 2. So both, now both of these two are in 90 degree, but the one is at clockwise, the other is anti-clockwise. So alpha 1 will be minus 90 degree because this is clockwise, this is anti-clockwise, so plus 90 degree. Alpha 1 is minus 90 degree, alpha 2 is 90 degree. Putting in equation number 1, everything is ready. Rho has been found. Okay, I is given, alpha 1, alpha 2. Okay, so now again in cylindrical coordinate system, transforming it into rectangular coordinate system, again we have only the phi term. So solving this matrix, rho into column, then rho into column, or hz rho into column. So hx is this, hy is this, hz is this, combining these two. Okay, this is h, so this is hx term, this is hy term, there is no hz term. Similarly, this is the hx, okay, minus 0.141 ex, because this is hx, and hy is 0.106. so now this, and in part 1, part a as well, this is hx minus 0.93 in the direction of ax. okay, and this is the hy in the direction of ay. okay, so that was all about the numerical of based on the Bio-Savart law. So thank you for the moment.